have already given you notes. Yes, Shashwat. Yes, Shashwat.
Ma'am, in the notes you have given, you notes you have given us. Ma'am, in the third page, it is written directly fourth and fifth point, not first, second, third.
What? Can you be clear?
Ma'am, after the mechanism of monsoon winds, the next page which you have sent, it is written fourth and fifth point, not first, second and third.
No, so you have, the first page I have sent you is of Kal Baisakhi. The loop.
Yes, ma'am.
See. First, you have started writing loo winds, the local winds of the hot, dry season. So, first was loo wind. After that, I have given you notes today of Kal Baisakhi and then the mango showers and cherry blossoms, etc. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Then, characteristics of hot, dry season.
Hot weather.
Right? After that, I had started the new season. After characteristics of monsoon. Hot weather season, the next season starts is the rainy season or the southwest monsoon season.
Monsoon season.
Is it clear?
Yes,
in this monsoon season, the first thing that you are going to write is what you understand by monsoon, then what is the mechanism of monsoon, how does it work, and that is what we are going to discuss today. Before that also, any question is there regarding factors affecting climate of India? Any question?
No, ma'am.
You understand how the climate of India at different places is different. This difference in climatic conditions all over the country, you can see that Himalayas and all the places which are located like Srinagar and Shimla and even Dehradun and all, they are cold. Delhi is hot. Agra, Jaipur, still we have so many variations in the climatic conditions of northern India, and when we come to South India, it is surrounded by water bodies on three sides, so the climate will remain colder, or we can say not colder, it is moderate, that is neither very hot nor very cold. So these are the effects of factors which affect the climate of India. Now today we start with any problem in the hot dry season. Anyone who is having any problem in the hot dry season, you can raise your hand. So shall I begin with the mechanism of monsoon winds? Yes, Devesh.
Ma'am, the Devesh. Notes which you have given after loo winds.
Uh-huh.
All the notes are for hot dry season only.
No, the notes for hot dry season, the notes will end till the characteristics of hot dry season. After that, the next season starts. You can see that in the notes. Mechanism of monsoon. No, the southwest monsoon season begins.
Okay.
Still, if you have a question, you can ask in between. Today, let me explain to you, I will try with the help of a map here, how the monsoon works. Okay, how does it come to India, what is the consequence, how is it distributed into, you must have seen if you have gone through the notes, just read it also, maybe not writing, but reading it also. You must have seen that there are two branches, one is Arabian Sea monsoon branch and one is the Bay of Bengal monsoon branch. So how does all these things happen? Let me explain it to you with the help of a map. Can you see the map?
इतने मोबाइल नहीं मिला तो कार दूध पहले ले बैठे लोग हुआ
एंकर लाग डाउन
for me because I do not know how much you are able to understand. Now, can you see the map of India? And in this map, you have to understand that India is having water bodies on three sides. So this is the Arabian Sea, this is the Bay of Bengal, and here we have the Indian Ocean. Indian Ocean. All these things are very important. Once you are discussing about the climate of India, these all things are very important. Now, you can see that India is having also a tapering shape. That is, the size of land is becoming narrow as we move towards the south. Is that clear? Now, below India, India starts from almost 8 degree north of the equator. That is, if we consider this line as equator, this line here as the equator, generally the wind system is like this, that to the north, we have in general the northeast monsoon winds blowing, and in the south we have the northeast trade winds. In the north, the winds blow general, these are the permanent winds. These permanent winds, when they blow, they actually are blowing throughout the year north, from the northeast direction. That is, they are known as northeast trade winds, and in the south they are called as southeast trade winds. I will write here southeast because they are important. Please, if you have any question, please raise your hand. If you're not able to see anything or something like that, please raise your hand. Okay? Now, with this, let us come back to one more important thing, and that is the Tropic of Cancer. The Tropic of Cancer passes from India in this manner. I'll make it to the darker shade so that you understand. This line, this latitude, which is 23.5 degree north of the equator, it almost passes from the center of our country. So with this, what happens is, on the 21st of June, we know that the sun rays fall vertically at the Tropic of Cancer, due to which the northern and northwestern part of our country, northern and northwestern, this part of our country, becomes extremely hot. Now, may I ask you a question? Why does it not become that hot in the southern part of the country? Why does it not become hot? Anyone can unmute? Okay. Yes, Divyash? Yes, Divyash. Why does it not become hot in the southern part?
Because the winds that blow from the equator, they make a climate really marine type climate in the southern of India.
It is because of the winds that blow from the equator.
Yes, ma'am. As the great winds from
no, it's not that. You are closer, but not Kanha.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm due to the surrounding seas. I'm moderating the influence of surrounding seas.
Right. It is due to the influence of the surrounding oceans and seas. Since India, the southern part of India, has a tapering shape, this influence of the sea is taken more towards the interior here. This part is completely surrounded by water and so it has moderate climate. But when the Tropic of Cancer, though it is passing from the center of India, still the northern part, which will become extremely hot during the summer season. Is it clear? So the northern part become extremely hot. So if a place becomes hot, what type of pressure do you understand? What type of pressure will be there?
A low pressure.
So here we can say that the northern part of India has a low pressure, especially where you can see this is Rajasthan, Punjab, Haryana, this area, extremely hot. Coming back to this, now when this is a low pressure here and the water body surrounding will have a comparative high pressure. Now coming back to this, let me tell you about one more thing. Do you know about land and sea breezes? The land and sea breezes are caused due to unequal heating of land and water. And that is why during the daytime, the sea, which is comparatively cooler, and land becomes immediately hot. And when the land becomes hot and sea is cooler, there will be a low pressure over the land and a high pressure over the sea. And the winds start moving from sea to land. I'm a bit fast. Let me explain once again. During the day, the land becomes hot. And so there is a low pressure over the land. At the same time, the sea, which will take more time to get heated up, it will be comparatively colder. And because of that, there will be a high pressure over the sea. So, the winds always blow from high pressure to low pressure. Thus, during the daytime, they will blow from sea to land. At night, what will happen? At night, the land becomes immediately cold, but the sea has now gained heat throughout the day. So now the sea will become warmer at night and the land will become colder. And now the winds will start blowing from the high pressure over the land to low pressure over the sea. Now because of this, the land and sea breezes blow and they moderate the climate of the area. Monsoon winds are actually periodic winds like the land and sea breezes, and they are also caused due to the unequal heating of land and water, but they are on a larger scale. Here, we are not talking about only the coastal area. Here, we are talking about the entire subcontinent and the entire water body surrounding. Now coming back to this, since these monsoon winds, they are seasonal winds and they have been caused due to the low pressure created in the northern or northwestern part of the country, and there is a high pressure over the oceans and seas. And below the equator, there are southeast trade winds. The direction of southeast trade winds, as you can see, they are like this. They are blowing from southeast. They are attracted towards this low pressure. That means they have to blow from this high pressure towards this low pressure. And as they cross the equator, due to Coriolis effect. Remember, what is Coriolis effect? Coriolis effect is the effect of rotation of Earth. It is when the Earth moves from west to east, the winds are thrown in an opposite direction of the movement of Earth. So here what happens that since the in the northern hemisphere, due to Coriolis effect, the winds are deflected towards their right and in the southern hemisphere they are deflected towards their left. Once again I am repeating, due to Coriolis effect the winds are deflected towards their right hand side, and in the southern hemisphere they are deflected towards their left. As you can see that these winds are moving towards left, but as they cross the equator, now they have entered the northern hemisphere after crossing the equator. So the same winds, they start blowing from, they have deflected towards their right now. They have deflected towards their right. Can you see this? They have deflected towards their right. And because of this, they start blowing from southwest. They start blowing from southwest. Clear? So what happens now, because of they're blowing from southwest and also that they are seasonal winds, monsoon winds are also called as southwest monsoons during summer. Any question till now? Any question? I'm waiting. Yes? Yes, Anshika Singh?
Ma'am, why the northwest part of India is warmer than northeast part?
What?
Ma'am, you have said that northern part is usually warmer than southern part of. But why the west part is warmer?
Okay, it is because you can see that in the eastern part, northeastern part of India, they are mostly surrounded by mountains and hills. Okay? There will be mountains, so the climate will be colder.
Okay?
Yes? Aditya, your question?
Yes,
can you be louder?
As the earth is inclined on its axis, when the sun rays fall vertically on the topic of Cancer,
right,
then the more amount of heat will be received by the northern part of the northern part or by the southern part.
See, you have to understand this. That is why we have discussed about the location of India. This India and the shape of India. You can look at this shape of India and location. You can see that India is in such a position that it is surrounded by water body from three sides, okay? And though the southern part of India comes under the torrid zone, it should be hotter. And the northern part is in the temperate zone, which should be colder. But here, opposite happens. Because of the tapering shape of India, as well as the moderating influence of the sea, the southern part of India, which is actually in the torrid zone, is much more moderated. Whereas northern part, which is in the interior, is having higher temperature. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Ma'am.
Any other question?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So can you see the map? Can you see the map now once again? Who is this raising hand? Shaurya Shivastav. Shaurya?
Yes, ma'am.
Your question?
Ma'am, I want to ask that in the western part of India,
right,
the Aravalli ranges are also there, na?
We will come back to that. Don't worry. That is another thing altogether. Okay? While discussing all this, you will see that in the notes you have written about it, about the Aravalli ranges also. I will come to that. Okay? So now coming back to this map work, once again I am repeating the entire process. It's very important. Once you know this, the entire chapter will be very easy for you. Now we are talking about the southwest monsoon season. As I've already informed you, monsoon means season. And season means these winds, which are periodic winds, during summer they blow from southwest. And why do they blow from southwest? I've explained to you that there is a low pressure created in the northwestern part of the country and northern and northwest. Not only it is here, all this area which is having the hot, dry season right now, they have a very high temperature. High temperature means low pressure. And to fill that, the winds from the southern hemisphere, that is the southeast trade winds, are attracted towards this. And when they are attracted, they are crossing the equator. As they cross the equator, they turn towards their right and they start blowing from southwest. They start blowing from southwest. Now, another important thing here is, this is the tapering shape of India. So when India is having the tapering shape, what happens is these southwest monsoon winds, which are, you can see there, they are coming from sea to land, this all the surrounding water bodies. And because of that, they have plenty of moisture in them. So these winds, due to the tapering shape, they are further divided into two sections. They are divided into two sections. So one, and the name which is given to the seas here, the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal. So what happens is, this branch of southwest monsoon is known as Arabian Sea branch. It is the branch of monsoon which is divided due to the shape of India into two parts. The southwest monsoons, when they blow from the Arabian Sea, they are called Arabian Sea branch of monsoon, and when they blow over the Bay of Bengal, they are known as the Bay of Bengal branch of monsoon. Clear? Now, even after this, you will see one more thing here, that when the Bay of Bengal branch starts coming, the first state to experience rainfall from these winds is Kerala. You can see this state is Kerala here. Kerala receives rainfall from the 1st of June onwards. It starts receiving the rainfall. And gradually, the amount and time keeps on increasing towards north. From Kerala, it moves towards Karnataka. Not at one time all the winds are blowing. They start approaching India gradually. Is that clear? They start approaching India. They start moving from south to north. And because of that, Kerala is the first state. Here, one very important fact is that we have the Western Ghats. I will also draw the Aravallis to make my explanation better, since you had a question here. So these are the Western Ghats. Can you see the Western Ghats? Okay. Now what happens is, when the winds, the Arabian Sea monsoon approach India, the coast of India, they approach the western coast, they are full of moisture, but the rainfall is mostly experienced on the western slopes of the Western Ghats. If you remember anything about the rain shadow area, the rains, most of the rains fall on the windward side. So this part of the Western Ghats, the western coast, you can say, it comes under the windward side of the mountain of the Western Ghats. So it receives plenty of rainfall. And just on the other side, this entire portion, the eastern part of the Deccan Plateau, eastern part of the Western Ghats, it does not receive much rainfall. Why is it? Because this comes under the rain shadow area. As the winds approach towards east, there are, the amount of rainfall will decrease, because most of the rainfall occurs on the western coast. So the amount of rainfall keeps on decreasing towards east, and that is one reason. Now there is also one more mountain here, and you know about them. You have done in class 8 also. These are the eastern Ghats. These are the eastern Ghats. So these are western Ghats. They stop the moisture and force them to shower most of the moisture on the western coast. By the time they reach the eastern part, again there are these mountains, the eastern Ghats, and because of that, they don't give rain to this part of the country. That is, it's very important to note it down now very carefully that the eastern coast of India does not get much rain during summer. Though we call it the southwest monsoon season, it is invariably the rainy season for India. Almost every part of the country gets rain, but due to certain factors, and if very importantly this factor, that the coast comes under the rain shadow region, it does not get much rainfall during the summer season. One thing is that it is not getting rainfall from Arabian Sea monsoon current. But what about the Bay of Bengal monsoon current? Why it is not giving rainfall to eastern coast? It is because they are lying parallel to the eastern coast. You can see they are moving from, in fact, the Bay of Bengal is moving straight away from here without causing any rainfall to the eastern coast. So there can be some amount of rainfall, and the first place to receive rainfall from Bay of Bengal monsoon current is which place? And that is the Andaman Nicobar Islands. They first receive rainfall from the Bay of Bengal monsoon current. Okay. Coming back to the Arabian Sea monsoon current, as I told you, the Arabian Sea monsoon current gives plenty of rainfall to the western coast. It starts from Kerala and then gradually it moves northward. But there are two further, now they are bifurcated. One branch enters through Narmada Valley and it gives rainfall to this part, that is Madhya Pradesh, receives rainfall from the Arabian Sea monsoon current because the winds get an opening through the Narmada Valley. This is river Narmada and this is river Tapi. So from there is no mountain range over here, and because of that they can enter here. Is it clear? So this part, that is Madhya Pradesh and some parts of Rajasthan, the eastern part of western part of Rajasthan, sorry, the eastern part of Rajasthan, they get some of the rainfall. But then when these winds move further northward, as you can see they have to enter the low pressure area, when they move northward, now here we have the Aravali ranges, and due to the presence of Aravali ranges, I hope it is clear, due to the presence of Aravali ranges, the Aravali ranges lie parallel to the Arabian Sea monsoon branch. As you can see that they lie parallel. Since they do not obstruct the rain-bearing winds, the western parts of Rajasthan and northern Gujarat, they become a desert. Okay? Since the Aravallis lie parallel to the Arabian Sea monsoon current, the western part of Rajasthan does not receive much rainfall. Much rainfall, it receives the westernmost part, in fact, receives hardly 5 to 7 centimeters rainfall. It's completely a desert area. Okay, then these winds move further northward. Yes, I'm coming to you. Kritin. Yes, Kritin.
Ma'am, western Ghats don't allow southwest monsoon to move into India, right?
No, I did not say that. You can see the direction. It is from southwest, right?
Yes.
And it has to further move northward to the low pressure.
So ma'am, they but are it allows the rain to shed in that area only, na?
Maximum rain. I'm not saying that the other part
ma'am,
does
so
not get it.
Farming must be extensive in that area.
Which area?
Ma'am, places around Western Ghats which receive maximum of the rainfall from
Which part receives maximum rain? The western coast. That is, if you think about Mumbai, Kochi, okay, all these areas, they receive plenty of rainfall, right?
Yes, is farming extensive in those areas? Like Mumbai has more trade and Goa is not based on farming, I guess.
Okay, see, it's what happens in there. There are, for farming, for agriculture, it's not only the rainfall which is important, it is also the relief feature, that is whether it is a plain or it's a hilly region, and different types of crops can be grown. Of course, farming is there. And farming is there in those part of India also where there is no rainfall. But they are like, they are very less rainfall. Those areas also have the farming. But they have farming with the help of irrigation. Okay?
And ma'am?
Huh?
Ma'am, the rainfall that is 5 to 7 centimeter, is it measured from the sea level? Ma'am, is it measured from the sea level of, or the ground level of the
rainfall be? Wait. How can rainfall be measured from sea level, beta? Rainfall isn't measured in centimeter. It's not the height, it is the amount of rain received by a particular area. From sea level, we measure the height of a place, okay? I'm not talking about the height.
Okay.
Clear? Huh. Any other question? You definitely can ask any other question if you have. No? Okay. Devesh? Yes, Devesh?
Ma'am, in Rajasthan, due to Aravali Hills,
right.
The rain-bearing winds are stopped.
They are not stopped. They are not stopped. It's not that they are stopped. I said they are not blocked by the Aravali. Why are they not blocked? Because the Aravali lies parallel to the direction of the Arabian Sea branch of monsoon. Parallel. If you remember the diagram, let us go back. I will draw one diagram here. I will draw a diagram. You remember this diagram? Can you see that? Okay. Can you see this? This is the sea. And here the winds are moving up from the sea. You remember? So this part will receive rainfall. This is called as windward side of the mountain. So the windward side of the mountain receives rainfall. And when these winds move toward the other side, this becomes a rain shadow area. Or it does not receive. Just a minute, please hold on. Just a moment. Yes, Kritin. Yes, Kritin.
Sorry, I forgot to lower my hand.
Achha, then just, have you understood what I said? Did you understand this figure that I have drawn just now?
Yes, ma'am.
Huh? This is what? It's a mountain. I want a sea. Smooth sea. They are motion winds. They are motion winds. And when they bring rainfall, they bring rainfall to this part of the mountain, it's called as the wind side. Plenty of rainfall is received here. But on the other side, the winds become, because they have already showered most of the rain on this side, the other side of the rainfall, which is mountain, which is called the leeward side, either receives very less rainfall or no rainfall at all. The same thing happens here also, okay? So, this part receives plenty of rainfall, while the other part, that is the Deccan Plateau, the central part of the Deccan Plateau, does not receive much rainfall. Clear? In this case, as I am again repeating it, please don't be confused. This is Aravalli Ranges, and when the Arabian Sea monsoon branch approaches northward, the Aravalli Ranges do not stop the rain-bearing winds since it lies parallel. And because of that, the western part of Rajasthan and the northern parts of Gujarat, they remain a desert, receiving very less rainfall. Okay? So this was all about the monsoon current, that is Arabian Sea monsoon. Now, let us start the Bay of Bengal. As I have already told you, the Bay of Bengal monsoon current are moving in such a manner that they do not bring much rainfall except for the coastal area somewhere here and there. Most of it moves parallel to the eastern coast, so does not bring much rainfall. The first place to receive rainfall is what? It is the Andaman Nicobar Island. After that, what happens? It enters here. Now, once again, I'm making some mountains here. As I told you, that this part is, many mountains are there. These are Himalayas. These are the Himalayas. Here we have hills. So all these mountains. And then we have the Arakan Yuma, which is an extension of the Himalayas. Can you see this? Himalayas. Here we have Garo, Khasi, Jayantia. These are hills. Mizo, Lushai, Naga hills. And then here we have Arakan Yuma in Myanmar. Why am I telling you all these things? They play a very important role in making India as it is, like the receiving of the rainfall by India during summer is because of this. So now what happens is, when the Bay of Bengal monsoon rainfall, yes, Devesh? Yes, Kana? Kana, you have a question?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, do eastern ghats bring rainfall on the windward side? Ma'am, do eastern ghats bring rainfall on the windward side?
No, it is not possible. Right now, you just try to understand one thing, that the rainfall which is received during the summer months is basically from the southwest monsoons, right? And yes, the southwest monsoons, can you still see the map?
Yes.
The southwest monsoons are approaching India from the west. So they are west, no, southwest. So they are approaching India from southwest.
Yes,
so the eastern part will not receive much rainfall during the summer season. Remember this, okay?
Okay. Thank you.
So, now coming back to this map. When this Bay of Bengal branch of monsoon moves further northward, they are trapped. These are the Garo, Khasi, Jayantia hills. They approach here. And this is the place, children, if you remember, Meghalaya. This is Meghalaya here. And they are now being blocked by the Garo, Khasi, Jayantia hills. Which branch of monsoon is being blocked? Now the Bay of Bengal monsoon. And they are trapped in this area in such a manner. These are very close mountains, and they form, the valleys of these mountains make such a condition that all the rainfall of the Bay of Bengal monsoon current, almost all, it falls at one place, and that place is Cherrapunji. You must have heard about it, the Cherrapunji. Cherrapunji and Mohsin Ram, which are located in Meghalaya, they are located on the windward side of these mountains, these hills in fact, the Garo, Khasi and Jayantia hills. So they get rainfall from the Bay of Bengal monsoon, and they receive, I'm talking about Cherrapunji and Mausinram, they receive the highest rainfall in the world. So this is one thing. Now what happens is another branch moves further northward, but here also, because of the because of Arakan Yoma and the mighty Himalayas, these winds are not able to cross the mainland of India, and they are deflected towards west. Can you see this? The winds which are approaching here, due to the presence of these mountain ranges, and the, if there is a small mountain, a hill, then the winds can cross the mountains, bringing plenty of rainfall on this side. But the other side of the mountain does not get much rainfall. But when the mountains, we are talking about Himalayas, the highest mountain ranges in the world, and this is also an extension of Himalayas, the Arakan Yoma, they do not allow the winds to move further north. So what happens? The winds get deflected because of that, and they start moving towards west. So as you can see, they are moving towards the west, means they are bringing rainfall to Assam, they are bringing rainfall to West Bengal, they are bringing rainfall to Bihar, to Uttar Pradesh, parts of Madhya Pradesh, Punjab and Haryana. And here they meet the Arabian Sea monsoon current and approach northward. Clear? Once again, I am repeating. Can you see this? Can you see the map? No, it will be dark. Okay. I'll do like this only. Once again, I'm repeating. This is the Bay of Bengal branch of monsoon. These winds, they give rainfall to Andaman Nicobar. They do not bring much rainfall to the eastern coast because they lie parallel. When they approach the mainland, there are hills like Garo, Khasi and Jayantia, and these hills form a barrier. And here we have the place which is having the highest rainfall in the world, that is Cherrapunji located. Anshika? Yes, Anshika?
Ma'am, the situation which happens here on, in Mausinram, the same happens on the western coast. So why
No.
Ma'am, it also falls on the west side. Sorry, ma'am, the west side.
Wait. Try to understand this. The western coast, it's a long range of mountain or hills. There's a long range of mountains or hills. They're lower. Here what happens, as I've told you, there are many more hills in this area.
Yes,
so, the valley portion, it acts as a funnel. Funnel, samajhte ho na? Funnel.
Yes, ma'am.
So, this particular area becomes like a funnel. And it almost takes up all the water which is coming through the Bay of Bengal current, and it receives the maximum rainfall here. This type of rainfall does not occur at any other place in India. No, in the world. This situation.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, means they all are concentrated there, and here
right.
In Western Ghats they are distributed as well.
Right.
Okay, ma'am.
Western coast also receives plenty of rainfall. The rainfall is more than 200 centimeters. As I told you, the Rajasthan, Jaisalmer, it got only 6 to 10 centimeters. Here, the western coast gets more than 200, 150 to 200 centimeters of rainfall during summer season. During the month.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Monsoon season.
And in Cherrapunji, the rainfall is 1,114 centimeters. Think about it. 1,114 centimeters. And that is because of this some special conditions made the valleys and the funnel shape of these mountains, they have created such a condition that once rainfall occurs. Same country, the same season, in the southern part of India, the maximum rainfalls in the west. And the amount of rainfall decreases towards the east. Clear? And in this case, we can see that even if these winds are moving, the Aravalli ranges block these winds also. They are not able to allow them to bring any moisture to this part of Rajasthan. So that becomes a completely rain shadow area. I hope this monsoon winds are clear. The Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal. Anything, any question? Because we have hardly 6 minutes left for today's session. Before we end the southwest monsoon season, it is important for you to know one or two things about this. First of all, most of India receives rainfall during this time. The rainfall, the amount of rainfall is never the same. It may be 200 on the western coast. It may be plenty of rainfall in the northeastern part of the country. But there can be moderate rainfall in this area, that is the northern part. And the Deccan part receives less rainfall. And the Jaisalmer area does not get any rainfall at all. So it's all because of the orographic nature of rainfall. Since orographic means the rainfall received by the presence of or obstruction of mountains. That is called as orographic. Oro means mountain. So the amount of rainfall received in India is not the same. And it is due to the presence of various relief features. And as I've told you, it is orographic. And third part is that almost every part of the country receives rainfall. One more thing about this season is that it is never, since the monsoon winds are dependent on the low pressure created, that is, the amount of heat should be more. If the monsoons have to occur, there has to be an intense low pressure. And it is not certain, like it is not like when we say that 1st of June the monsoons arrive Kerala, it is not always. Certain years it may even enter before time, and in another year it can be even the month of June also crosses and there is no rainfall. So what does it mean? The amount of rainfall is uncertain, sorry, the amount of rainfall is not evenly distributed, and the time of rainfall is uncertain. Sometimes it may be early and sometimes it may be late. Yes Devesh.
Ma'am, the northeastern part is not near the water body, so how it receives plenty amount of rainfall?
As I told you children, that the Bay of Bengal, see, the Bay of Bengal monsoon current, Bay of Bengal is a water body which can get plenty of rainfall to amount of moisture to the Bay of Bengal monsoon current. And this entire region, it is actually the Bay of Bengal monsoon current. There are three branches. One is which goes directly towards the north and it is giving rainfall to Mausandaram. The second branch which goes, but it is not obstructed anywhere. It finally goes here. Can you see the camera? The map? It finally goes here and then they are obstructed and they cause rainfall from this place and then they are deflected. Okay? to understand.
Yeah.